What's up, Zelda fans? The Legend of Zelda, Breath of the Wild took the gaming world by storm, and now we're eagerly awaiting its sequel, Breath of the Wild 2. But what about the upcoming game, The Legend of Zelda, Tears of Kingdom? Could it spell the end of the entire franchise? In this video, we'll explore the possibility of TOTK being the final Zelda game. First, let's talk about the Zelda series progression, which is based on the continuity established in Skyward Sword. In that game, Demise curses future generations to face his evil, specifically those who fill Link and Zelda's archetypal roles. The Link and Zelda of TOTK are chronologically the youngest generation in the series, as both BOTW and TOTK take place long after previous games. Even so, their connection to the past and their placement in the series' timeline point toward a possible end to Link, Zelda, and Demise's intergenerational conflict. But wait, you might say, Link has defeated Demise before, so why would TOTK be any different? Well, the Zelda team has not been afraid to show Link fail or even die, as we've seen in certain Ocarina of Time continuities. And in response to Link's failure in that game, the Zelda team created a three-way timeline split that saw the hero's adventure branch into different paths. For TOTK to end the series, then, it would need to somehow cease the timeline and prevent further timeline splits, a nigh-impossible feat. So how might TOTK do this? Well, it could create a time loop by shaping Zelda's timeline into a circle, as the ancient etchings shown in the game's first official trailer suggest. In these etchings, a Zelda-like figure can be seen cupping hands with Hylia, possibly implying that Zelda will become Hylia again in the effort to save Hyrule. This would create a cycle in which Hylia and Zelda have to transform into each other to protect the kingdom, ultimately bringing the Zelda timeline back to where it was in Skyward Sword. This theory is supported by TOTK's logo, an Ouroboros featuring two dragons consuming each other's tails to form a single whole. This could symbolize Zelda and Hylia creating their own cycle of endless return by transforming into each other in the eternal battle between good and evil. And since Skyward Sword represents the beginning of this cycle where Hylia becomes the mortal Zelda, TOTK must represent the end of this cycle where Zelda becomes the immortal Hylia. But what about Breath of the Wild 2? Doesn't that game take place after TOTK? Yes, it does. And that actually makes the end of Zelda all the more likely. BOTW merged the split timelines that follow Ocarina of Time and set up an identity conflict for Zelda that is bound to play out in TOTK. A century before BOTW, Zelda wrote in her journal that Hylia appeared to her in a dream one night. Shortly afterward, she was able to use the power of the Triforce when defending Link. Hylia's reappearance in TOTK could be the culmination of this identity conflict, and the end of the entire Zelda franchise. So, is The Legend of Zelda, Tears of Kingdom going to be the final game in the series? It's hard to say for sure, but the symbology, lore, and design of TOTK do suggest that it's a possibility.